calor está de madre. Me he bañado 4 veces y no son ni las 2. Me senté en la silla al patio y un huevo se me quemó. Algo pasa en Puerto Rico. Esto no era así cuando yo era chiquitito. Se podía jugar feliz. Y no quiero seguir bebiendo más cerveza. Bien deshidratado con dolor de cabeza. Algo pasa. Qué clase de calor. Oh, 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 oh. Qué clase de calor.
Prepara, prepara.
Oh, oh, oh. Qué clase de calor. Oh, 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 oh. Qué clase de calor.
Coco pa' la seca, que este calor está de madre ñeta. Y en la calle se siente el vapor. Oh, 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 fría, ya. Hoy me pongo el corto y salgo en chancleta. Después de las 12 que aprieta. Mejor salgo cuando baje el sol. Pa' la charca, pa' el chorro, pa' allá es que voy yo. Pa' la playa, pa' el río, pa' allá vamos con tú. Tú me dices te sigo y la gota es sudor.
Voy saliendo, bajando, caliente, me siento en el viento, no sopla el aire, no prende, ay Dios. De nuevo hay otro pago. Voy saliendo, bajando, caliente, me siento en el viento, no sopla el aire, no prende, ay Dios.
Hello, hello. Good afternoon, buenas tardes. If you can hear me, follow me and this beat. So I'm gonna play a beat and then I wanna hear it back to see if you, mi gente, have sabor. You ready? Pa, 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 pa. Not bad, one more time. Pa, 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 pa. Eso. Hola, hola, mi gente. My name is Melinda Ramirez, and I am ACES Director of Leadership Programs. Y me siento muy excited to be here today, closing out day 2, right? With our wonderful programs overview, graduation, and celebration with the happy hour afterwards. Wepa! So, as I always love to say, my Dominican Puerto Rican family, we like to celebrate by saying wepa. So at the end of this graduation, I'm gonna ask you to help our ACE familia celebrate not only this amazing ACE team, everybody behind the scenes, our IT tech staff, as well as our caterers, et cetera, to really just celebrate you being here and advancing positive impact. So with that said, we're gonna kick it off with just a little bit about what we are, who we are, and what we do. So our wonderful programs team, if we can move to the next slide, will be focusing on our wonderful programs here. So you're gonna get to know them. What we like to do with our programs to advance positive impact is that we have a pipeline all the way from our high school students up to the executive level. So that's a way that we develop that pipeline and have a multi-generational support network. So we want people to come in at every phase of their career, meet them where they're at, have them come back, share their successes, their struggles, and their lessons learned, because when we all grow together, we can inspire and make impact. And with that said, we had great impact. We had over 400 graduates this year. Give it a round of applause. Not only representing the U.S., Puerto Rico, but also 7 other countries. So yes, we are international and growing. We also have been super busy, and you're gonna meet my wonderful team. And we had inaugural programs kick off. We have more offerings coming up. So my team is gonna share a little bit about the program highlights. And then we're gonna ask if there's any graduates in the room when you see confetti on the screen to just stand up, celebrate, and then of course, enjoy and celebrate a happy hour. Sounds good, mi gente? All right, so we're gonna advance and move forward to talk about El Futuro. We're gonna have my colleague, Noel, talk a little bit about himself and the program. Noel?
Hi, everybody. It feels weird being in this room and not dancing with all of you. That was really fun. My name is Noel Rodriguez. I'm the brand new program manager.
Whoop,
two
whoop.
Weeks and two days. I'm so happy to join this team and be here with all of you. I am Cubano. I was born in Cuba, moved here when I was 7 years old. I will be overseeing our El Futuro college leadership, some of our professional workshops, and our scholarship programs. And I'm so happy to be here. I first want to tell you about El Futuro, which is the future. El Futuro helps our next generation with college and career readiness. This year, we graduated 39 total high school graduates.
Woo!
Give it up for that. Our spring 2023 cohort was sponsored by the Central Intelligence Agency and Ferrara Candy Company and graduated 20 Chicago public schools students. And then our fall 2023 was a nationwide cohort of graduates. They each received $250 stipends for a total of $4,750 from the Central Intelligence Agency as well. I'll pass it over to my colleague, Stephen.
Yes, hello. Saludos a todos, Stephen Hodge, Program Manager at ACE, and I have the honor of overseeing our University Leadership Program, which is focused on university juniors and seniors, equipping them to enter the workforce and to get a head start on their career. Our last cohort last year, we had a total of 22 graduates, and we're excited to announce, yes, that thanks to our partners with Ferrara, we were able to lead that cohort. So university leadership going strong and continuing this year as well.
And fun fact, not only did they learn, but they each got a $1,000 stipend.
Yes.
So that way they can pay for their expenses, help themselves and their families too. So shout out to our sponsors for helping them out with that. And now our Mujeres de ACE program manager, Bernice.
Hello, hello. So to tell you a little bit about Mujeres de ACE, now in its 16th year, Mujeres de ACE helps unlock your fullest potential by tapping into our Latinidad and acknowledging as our superpower, recognizing how our cultural values like humility can limit us in the corporate space, preventing us from advancing in our careers, which has a lasting impact on ourselves, on our families, and our community. I myself stand at the testament of the Mujeres de ACE program. I will tell you, I attended in spring of 2021. In February of 2022, I left an organization. I opened my own small business. In March of 22, I joined ACE. And then in August of 22, I graduated and obtained my BA in organizational leadership.
Go, and girl.
And I will say that none of that would have happened if not for the training and unlocking my potential from the Mujeres de ACE program. So as you can see on the screen, we graduated 141 alum in the last year, adding to our 3,200 plus alumni community. So I just want to remind you, las mujeres, donde hay una, estamos todas, okay?
Right. And we're so grateful for our partnerships who helped us with partial scholarships to make this happen, and our corporate sponsors too. And now we have on our inaugural program, which Stephen will talk about.
¿Dónde están los hombres?
I know, you're like, who needs them? But they're here, Well, with such a, I know, it's okay. But with such a legacy like Mujeres de ACE, it was time to start Hombres de ACE, and I had the great honor also of being able to be a part of the inaugural cohort for Hombres de ACE, where it's the brother program to Mujeres, where we're addressing issues of Marianismo, machismo, and equipping hombres to be better leaders and more equitable leaders in the workplace, yeah, so that everybody can rise up. So that's right. The importance of Hombres de ACE, of what we're offering. And with our inaugural cohort, we did have 15 graduates last fall. Hombres is planning to continue going strong this year, and we're excited for the support to keep it going. So thank you.
That's awesome. And before we move on to our next program, we do recognize that Mujeres and Hombres are binary programs. So we have gone intersectional, and we have the Colores LGBTQIA+ program that is going to be launching in 2025 to make sure we realize we're not monolithic, we're right. Not binary too. We want to have spaces within our own community to recognize, support, and create safe spaces. So that's coming soon. So next year, be prepared for that special graduation. And now we're going to have Lisandra talk about our next program.
Hola, hola. Thank you for being here. I'm Lisandra Jimenez. I'm also a proud Cubana as well. So I joined the ACE team almost 2 years ago, and I lead our mid-level professional program. So one of those is Elevando Latino Leadership Program. So it's specifically catered for mid-level professionals, and that tends to be between 5 to about 10 years of experience is that sweet spot. We get a couple that are a little bit more advanced. But it's meant to take high potential leaders and transform them, help them enhance their skills to become even more high performing leaders in their organizations, continue to move up in their industry of choice, and equip them with those leadership skills that they need to be able to move up in that pipeline. So this past year in 2023, we had 91 total graduates for this program, split into two different seasons. So in the springtime, we had two different cohorts with 32 graduates, and then in the fall, we had three cohorts, and for that, we had 59 graduates. And as you can see, international as well, with a couple of different countries represented besides the U.S. In addition to our regular Elevando program, we had a variety of different iterations of the program as well. We had a couple of partners that we had, and so we had three different partnerships for Elevando. One of them was with another nonprofit organization, so we co-collaborated with a nonprofit named La Plaza of Delaware, located in Delaware, and serve the immigrant population in Delaware, which you'll be surprised, there is a lot over there. So we collaborated with them and launched a cohort of 15 participants that graduated last year in Delaware with that collaboration. In addition, we had a collaboration with Freddie Mac, one of our partners. We had an exclusive cohort of Latinas, specifically, under the Elevando program, and we graduated 15 of those within the D.C. and Virginia area, and that cohort was named Elevando Mujeres de ACE due to its specificity for Latinas. And then we also had a partnership with Trellix. I know you all have seen Trellix around as well in the conference. They sponsored 18 individuals as well that graduated last year and had an exclusive cohort of all individuals from different areas that were specifically interested in cybersecurity. So being able to grow that population in our Latino community, bring more folks into that industry, and we had 18 graduates for that collaboration of that program. So thank you to those sponsors and the graduates. Congratulations.
All right. And before we move to our next program, if you're a little old school like me, Elevando was named Leadership Academy, then evolved to elevating Latino leaders. But when we realized at the mid-level, they were already elevating or emerging Latinos, let's take them to the next level that they can elevate their communities. So if you're wondering the name switch, that's what happened because you all provided that great feedback. So your feedback is very important because we take that definitely into consideration. And our next program?
Our other mid-level program is our Multicultural Leadership Program. So although primarily we do serve the Latinx, Latine community, we also serve multicultural professionals. So if you're in the room and you know your organization can benefit from this, remember that we also serve beyond just the Latino community. Our multicultural leadership serves, ideally, we try to get about 1/3 from different particular communities. So 1/3 Latinx, Latine, 1/3 from the AAPI community, Asian Pacific Islander, and 1/3 Black African American community as well. So we try to have that variety of mix. This past cohort actually had even indigenous representation, Native American representation. So we had a wide range of individuals. We had 26 graduates for this program last fall with a variety of different industry backgrounds. And then you can see from the U.S. and Canada as well.
That's right. And not only do we just do educational program, we also got into the business sector. So we started off, if you see the theme of the younger generation where we focus on foundation, leading self. Then we have ELLP, Elevando, multicultural. Well, now you're leading others. Now we're taking it to the next level where you can lead businesses and organizations. And one of those programs is Mujeres de ACE Entrepreneur.
So the other side of our Latino community is our entrepreneurial spirit, right? We keep hearing about that. It's important that we acknowledge why programs like Mujeres de ACE Entrepreneurs that dedicate resources, expertise, and mentors to help those businesses grow. a little bit more data before you leave for the day. Latino-owned businesses outpace the growth rates in number of businesses and revenue compared to any other group. Es más, the number of Latino-owned businesses is growing 10 times faster than any other group, and for Latinas, 6 times faster. So no nos estamos quedando atrás, right? And our impact doesn't stop there. We are also creating more jobs and with better benefits for those people in our organization. So there's no denying that we make an economic impact and that it is only growing. We heard the data from Ana Valdez and Silvana Montenegro, and what I felt was the call to action to really have awareness of your choices and understanding how you can empower los miembros de nuestra comunidad by supporting their businesses, their work, and their purpose, because our business is tied to our purpose. It's our why. And so when you support and you really use that spending dollar, you're making an intentional choice of who you're going to support and empower.
Preach. How about those Snapple fun facts, right? Those numbers are looking real nice. And to close us out with the pipeline is the Alza Advanced Latino Leadership Program, which we are so great to have worked with JP Morgan's Chase, Advancing Hispanic and Latinos. And this whole part was to get us through the spectrum of transformational leadership, where it's really taking your leadership to evolving and supporting the organization to the next level. And we worked with amazing executive directors from JP Morgan Chase to take them to the next level. And you'll find out that there's great news shortly after graduation that they're going to be speaking about fun facts and promotions. And to talk a little bit about Alza, we had 14 total graduates, executive directors. I see some in the room. Wink, wink. Hi. And we had a 10-month hybrid program. We went to different places. We had retreats. We had neuro-executive coaching with our wonderful partner, Life Coaching Group, led by Marlene Gonzalez, who's in the crowd somewhere, Carlos Gonzalez, and her wonderful executive coaching team, who talked about the brain science of leadership to understand what triggers, what are some barriers, but also how we can utilize neuroplasticity to formulate behaviors to help us advance our careers, our community, and our organizations. So we have the lovely guest, Kristen Coleman, who will be speaking on behalf of Silvana Montenegro. So if you're wondering, that is not Silvana, but she is another phenomenal jefa who made this happen. So welcome, Kristen Coleman.
Gracias, Melinda. Lo siento, you get jefa number 2, not Silvana. Thank you so much for the team. Thank you so much for all of you being here today. It's been an amazing second day of the summit. I just want to say a big thank you to Melinda, to Patricia, to Marlene. They have been such phenomenal partners. As our global head of employee engagement for Advancing Hispanics and Latinos, our mission over the last three years has been to increase representation, to provide career development. We've been doing this on a holistic level through all of our career development ERG sessions. We have an Avanzando Career Series, thanks in partnership to ACE. But we were really excited about this ALSA program because as we think about the data, as we think about the disproportionate representation among Latinos and getting them to the C-suite, ALSA was a way for us to pilot the inaugural cohort and really make sure that we gave voice to the fact that our employers have to provide investment so that Latinos can grow and thrive and that we can provide resources, tools, a network. We became familia through this. So I want to make sure that when we take a look at our 14 folks that participated, I'm honored that 6 of them came out today from all across the country, all across lines of business. You've heard yesterday and throughout the conference, which is okay that they stole my thunder.
Let them know, let them know.
that 4 of those individuals were just announced yesterday as recently promoted managing directors at JP Morgan.
Woohoo!
I want to make sure that we call out the team here. They are here with us. So just a quick un aplauso otra vez.
Right, stand up.
It's important that representation matters in this conversation. So as we pull the thread on the data that you heard yesterday and the continuing network of Latinos that need to support and lean into one another, I encourage you to take the best of what you've heard over these last 2 days and really lean in and challenge your organizations and really think about how you're expanding your network and what tools you need for success. So we know that creating a pathway to success is not an individual task. We know that it's a holistic effort, and we hope that you continue to stay motivated through self-determination, through sacrifice, mentors, family, and community, because this is what it was all about through Alza. It was a 10-month process. I couldn't be more thankful to the ASA team that they were partnering with us through this system, this process, that we trusted it. The fact that we were able to bring neuroscience into the conversation. Marlena, gracias. We shared insights and knowledge and tears and cultural relevance, and I think that was the most beautiful part of this work together. So I'm excited that for those that you have not had the opportunity to see this in action, lean in, take advantage. We're super excited that we're going to continue the partnership and continue to share that this is possible and this is necessary in the book of work that we do around advancing Latino careers. So thank you to everyone. And thank you to the ASA team, and especially to my squad that is here. Gracias.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Kristen. So before we really applaud the stars of the show, which are the graduates, I just want to take a second, and let's give a round of applause to the program's team. Who really give their heart, their soul, and everything to just make sure that we amplify voices, that we put people in the right spaces, that we help them achieve personal and professional success. So I really just want to acknowledge you all. You know that I love you all. I appreciate that. Our partners, our asset team, our coaches, our program leads, we could not do this without them all. And as I say, when one grows, we all grow. We're our community. And with that said, for those of you who are 2023 graduate, please stand up so we can do a loud whip. Let's get up. Don't be shy. Stand up. All right, so join me on the count of three. 1, 2, 3 with the wepa. Wepa! All right. Y con eso, mi gente, we just want to say thank you so much for being with us for 2 fun-filled, packed days. I'm still tired for doing some samba and having great time networking last night. We hope that you join us right across the hall with some networking, good music, and please enjoy and celebrate our graduates. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Have a wonderful day, mi gente.
No me lo niegues, yo sé lo que sientes, yeah. Yo sé lo que sientes, no te hagas la difícil, yo sé lo que sientes, yeah.